Let me get really clear on this. Anxious feelings do not mean that you are interminably broken. Anxious feelings are the mark of a self-adjusting, self-sensing nervous system seeking to re-regulate itself. Just like when your skin is healing from a wound and there's feelings of burning or itching during the healing process. When it comes to anxious feelings, that's like the pain of healing and readjustment. And so there are ways of working with that. There are ways of removing the blockage that's keeping your self-sensing, self-adjusting nervous system moving towards the internal goal of healing and regulating. When it comes to the methods for doing this, there are approaches I would call front door approaches, some that I'd call side door approaches, and some that really I would call back door approaches. And truly, most therapeutic methods, whether you're looking at cognitive therapies or EMDR or other types of therapies, most of them are going to be a combination of at least front door and side door approaches, if not a bit of back door work as well. So let me explain this just a bit. Front door approaches typically involve cradling the feeling and the responses in our awareness and getting curious about them instead of afraid of them. And so some of the front door approaches that I use often would be the mindfulness-based approaches using interoception and proprioception. These would be like somatic experiencing or sensorimotor psychotherapy. Somatic learning is another approach like that, as well as there's other very body-based somatic approaches. Those are front door approaches because you're looking directly at sensation. And sometimes that's the best thing. It's gentler than most exposure therapies and more direct. For other people, that's overwhelming. And so we would want to take more of a side door approach and start working in approaches where we leverage nature's dissociative mechanisms, like basically taking a step away from direct sensations before getting into your feelings. And so some of the side door approaches that I use, that I've seen other use, would be like self-hypnosis training, imagery techniques that are derived from some of the neuro-linguistic programming models, basically using imagery first to take you a step away from the direct sensations before working with the sensations just a little bit at a time. And also, when you think about meditative approaches that use imagery or spiritual symbology, sometimes even non-dualistic dialogue where you get talking about your connection with a broader set of things in the universe, those things take you a step away from sensation and are very useful side door approaches. Really any approach where you use imagination to step just a bit away from body sensations, figure ground shifting, things like that, including when it comes to a medicated approach, slower step, more stepwise ketamine protocols combined with therapy, those also are like a side door approach because you'll start with just a bit of testing the medication, seeing how you respond to it. And then in your neuroplastic state, you try to schedule your therapy appointments within a couple days after your administration so that you can start using that more open feeling state to do therapy. Also, with those ketamine approaches, they'll usually include journaling and things like that. So let's talk about backdoor approaches. Backdoor approaches would involve something that more completely either shuts down or bypasses the feeling system and then allowing for re-engagement. The re-engagement is unavoidable. And so you're never really fully stepping away. And a lot of times on your way into doing a backdoor approach, you're going to start feeling stuff and having something to engage with. But one of the more aggressive ones would be the electroconvulsive therapies, where they use the complete like sort of brainstorm to shut things down and re-engage. Deep hypnosis training would be another backdoor approach, except that on the way there, when you're training to go into a deep hypnotic state, you're going to confront stuff on the way down. It's almost unavoidable unless you're one of those people who can go into a deep hypnosis state really rapidly and easily. A smaller percentage of the population seems to have that talent already built up. But anyway, also deep brain transcranial magnetic stimulation would be more of a backdoor approach because you're bypassing the active systems and doing some tests on how the brain is functioning and then going in. As opposed to, say, like neurofeedback, where you're very aware of what's going on and you're actively doing stuff with the deep brain TMS, somebody else is sort of doing the analysis and the machine is going in. So I'd call it a backdoor approach. And so just when I'm explaining these things, the main point is you are not just a person stuck with your anxious responses forever. And your anxious responses at their root have something good that you can work with. You have power to go in and do something about this thing that keeps getting in the way of your functioning. You are not broken. And when it comes to taking something that's designed to go right and doing some work with it, there are ways of doing that.